Hello, we are discussing about GATE 1996 ECE paper, and this is one more question related to electronics. The P-type substrate in a conventional PN junction isolated integrated circuit should be connected to A. Nowhere, B. DC ground potential, C. The most positive potential available in the circuit, D. The most negative potential available in the circuit. The P-type substrate in a conventional PN junction isolated integrated circuits should be connected to. The answer is most negative potential available in the circuits. Answer is D. So generally the P-type substrate in case of IC, substrate is also called as, okay, substrate. The other names for the substrate are, they are called as bulk or body. So bulk or body or substrate, the main function of this one is nothing but it act as base for the integrated circuits. Base for the integrated circuit is nothing but you can fabricate any number of transistors on this base. Okay, so the base should not affect the operation of integrated circuits. So you can think what is the meaning of base means. If you are going to be looking at the blackboard, okay, and the blackboard is going to be acting as base for the letters what you are going to write on. If the blackboard is not used and simply you are writing the letters on air, it is not visible. So that implies nothing but while writing with chalk, the letters requires a base so that it is going to be visible and useful. In the same way, okay, the board is nothing but substrate and the letters are nothing but transistors. Okay, so here it is, the substrate is nothing but simply acting as a base for the integrated circuits fabricated on that one. So it should not affect the operation of the circuits fabricated on that one. By that time, the P-type substrate should be connected to more negative potential available in the circuits. Generally it is VSS, because we are going with two power supplies. Generally one is nothing but VDD, the other is VSS. So P-type substrate is always connected to VSS, the most negative potential, such that, okay, if any N-type material is going to be making a junction with this P-type substrate, it act as reverse bias and no current is going to be contributed, no operation is going to be performed by this reverse bias PN junction. Okay, so P-type substrate, even if it is going to be like this, even if you are going in this way, this is P-type substrate. Okay, but whenever we are going with something as N-type, okay, so this PN may looks like a PN junction, but this should not affect, the operation of IC. By that time, this P substrate is going to be connected to most negative potential, so that always this PN junction will be under reverse bias. So this doesn't have any effect on the circuit operation. That's why the P-type substrate in conventional PN junction is always connected to the most negative potential available in the circuit.